Harry Weinstein, burger, the Diddy movie's boss. His last few films are flopped with catastrophic money loss. So he's touching Diddy movies for the thrill of television. The small screen is the future for those with any vision. With Larry's bottom dollar, he's launched the TV station. Packed with creativity, style and innovation. Diddy TV, Diddy TV, channel 6, 5, 9, 7, 4, 2, 3. A brand new rival for the BBC. It's Diddy and Dom's Diddy TV.
There's a change to the schedule now, as we've been forced to bring you an important programme in a last-ditch bid to keep our broadcasting licence. Meet Michael Nixon, a boy born with a rare genetic condition. Michael was born with a spoon for a nose.
You get used to the stairs. Oh, it could be worse. I've met kids with chopsticks for eyebrows. I've even met one girl who had a garlic crusher for a chin.
That's it, Michael. Give it a good thwack. It's very handy. I'm never looking for a teaspoon, that's for sure.
Michael? Thank you, Michael.
I like to make myself useful.
Although sometimes that's easier said than done.
Why does everything smell of sugar?
Actually, Michael's case is quite funny. Rare. It's rare. Unfortunately, there's nothing we can do. In fact, his condition will only worsen with age. Oh, sorry. That chart just makes me hungry.
Michael, your spoon's breaking up the picture again.
Oh, sorry, Dad. Well, Dad, there's somebody I'd like you to meet. This is my girlfriend, Jessica.
Pleased to meet you.
Oh, no. There's two of them.
Jeff, pleased to meet you, love. Sorry. I said pleased to meet you, love. Sorry, I can't hear you. I've got forks for ears.
Handy for eating spaghetti, I suppose.
And so things are finally looking up for Michael, the spoon-nosed boy.
Oh, give us a cuddle.
You prongs! Fork ears!
Spoon nose!
Although there is
still a long way to go.
What a tragic story, eh, Barney? Really makes you think.
Yeah. Makes me think it's time for a bowl of cereal. Or some soup.
Making an insightful, caring documentary like that really takes hard work and dedication, doesn't it?
I guess so.
But I made it, so that means I'm a really hard-working and caring person, doesn't it?
Yes.
So, as a hard-working and caring person, can I please have a Blue Peter badge?
No.
What has two eyes, a beak, and spits poisonous venom? An octopus, of course. Nature's most misunderstood mollusk. They're lovable, affectionate, and when they cuddle, they never let go. It's time to change people's hearts and minds about these carnivorous aquatic nightmares, which is why this year we're asking you to be a sucker for Octoberpus.
I'm a sucker for Octoberpus! I'm a sucker for Octoberpus!
I'm a sucker for Octoberpus! Help!
Yes, be a sucker this October. Buy one of our non-removable rubber suckers and we'll make sure that some of all of the money goes directly to helping octopuses. Whoever you are, make this October Octoberpus.
Octo-fun.
And they will thank you with every one of their three hearts.
Sensitive viewers should be aware that this next programme is equally bad for everyone.
Hello and welcome to Diddy Pops. We are blessed tonight, ladies and gentlemen, singing a timeless love song that's been topping the charts for a full 16 weeks. please give it up forever and ever for Diddy Dom and the Jitters!
As we watch our intrepid explorers get eaten by animals up Diddy Creek.
This part of Africa is home to the most aggressive mountain gorillas in the world. To survive, all we need to remember is not to feed them.
Wait! Where's Dom? Why, you see, the stock market can crash at any moment overnight. Much more of a global crisis. Yeah.
If you feed a mountain gorilla, it forms an unbreakable bond and will never ever leave you.
Dom! No! What?
Gruesome misfortune served up for your viewing pleasure now in Crimediddy.
Mum! Mum! I've told you before, didn't call us at work, Mum! Man! Oh! Hoa! A near body move. Welcome to another edition of Crimediddy with me, Diddy D.A. Harry Batt. And this week, it's full of mystery. What's happened to this Diddy's eyebrows? Whose mug is this? And why has nearbody told me I've got my trousers on back to front? But first, we're off to a school in Whitby, where things have been gone missing. Run VT. This is Jeff. He loves nothing more than sitting at the front of the classroom and dreaming up new punishments for the bairns.
Ooh, a concrete board rubber boomerang.
Makes me sick. But last Monday morning, Jeff noticed that something was missing. That's right, the bird was a lesser spot of Diddy Pie, but more importantly, the leaves were nowhere to be found.
Sir, Jeff, when did you first notice?
Oi! Get on, get hold of it, man.
Okay.
What will you be taking by that? Sounds nothing like me. Sir, these leaves, have they gone missing before?
It happens every year. There's a serial leaf thief.
Hold on a moment. They go missing every year. What, round about autumn time?
How do you know?
Ganon, get out of it, man, and day one. Yeah? Sir, you can all sleep easy in your beds, like.
Are we? What's going on? I'm the real Harry.
Ah, no, you're not. I'm the real Harry Batt. Hold on a moment. There's two of yous. Right, come here. Mom! God! Sorry, son. It was that's the only way we could get to see us.
You're so busy with work, love. We miss you.
Right, yes, both nicked. Now remember, crimes like this that feature your parents dressing up as me are very, very rare. So, the best way not to have nightmares is never gone to sleep. So, until the next time, mind how you got.
Come on, Nick.
What are you doing, Barney? I'm just checking I'm not my mum dressed up as me. No, not me. You. Yeah, but still, making a show to help fight crime is a really good cause, isn't it?
Totally.
And I made that too, so that must mean that I'm a really good person, right?
Yes.
So, I was wondering, just possibly, maybe...
Can I have a new Peter badge, please?
No!
Oh.
Previously on the next Diddy. Chuck was unhappy with Rad for dancing with Courtney, which made Chelsea angry because she wanted to dance with Rad, but Dexter said she wasn't allowed to, so she tried to dance with Chuck instead. But Chuck had already said he'd only dance with Dexter and Rad, which made Courtney look bad, so... Seriously, it's episode 98. If you don't know by now, you never will. Let's dance!
We made it to the regional finals of the Matey Uppy Dance Competition. Woohoo!
Okay, guys. We made it!
I don't know how we got here, but we made it.
I came by bus.
My mom dropped me.
Walked. It doesn't matter. I mean, what matters is we earn it. Feel clap. Now, go get him.
Dexter, everyone's got cool monster costumes, and I can't even see.
Oh yeah, here we go. What a prima donna.
Can't I be like a werewolf?
It's too late. You're on.
Sight, for my monster from its slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on and flashed.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
They did the mash.
Worth a Blue Peter badge, I don't know what is.
Larry, I'm sorry, I can't just hand out Blue Peter badges. There are rules. You only get them for very specific reasons.
Like what?
Well, for gold, acts of selflessness or heroism.
Yeah, what else?
For a green badge, you've got to do something for the environment.
What else?
You could draw a picture.
With these hands?
Good point.
Oh, Barney, you're killing me here.
Well, there is one more thing you could try, Larry.
Like what?
You could try asking me nicely.
Seriously? Okay, here goes. Barney, could I please, 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 please have a Blue Peter badge?
Yes. In fact, here's one I made earlier.
That's it for Diddy TV today, and all that remains is for me to go... goodbye.